Ever notice how the European maps are always larger and wider than the others?
Huh?
You know, the streets are outrageously wide while the humans remain the same size. The scales is totally off.
No, not that. We are talking about actual paper maps.
Please, boss, look who's a technologically savvy bum.
I mean, I understand if you lacked in those maps before throwing them in a barrel or something.
I'll throw you in a barrel in a second.
Whatever. Wanna get into Ixva?
You know something about how to get there?
See that unguarded sewer access behind that building?
I guess I can check it out.
Talk to the bump in the building. He can help you get it open.
Sure. Thanks.
Aren't you too dark for a stormtrooper?
Classy.
Look, I ain't leaving tonight.
I'm not here for that. I was wondering if you could help me get inside the Exva building.
The sewer access behind this building can take you there.
Yeah, I heard you can help me with getting it open.
Oh, that's true. But you've got to do a thing for me first.
Of course. What do you need?
A pack of cigs.
Here you go.
Do you mind if I puff out a few?
That's fine. I secondhand smoke 2 packs a day.
I don't know what that means. As a matter of fact, I'm going to throw these away. I just wanted to see if you're the type of guy who carries cigs around.
These baggy coats must be augmented.
Anyway, here's the key. In the long term, breaking into Exva is much less of a risk to your health than smoking.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I., go away.
Thank you. Thank you. Project Mad Ingram, in the flesh. It seems that your abilities were not over-exaggerated.
You must be Navakova, right? The head of Exva?
I guess you caught me there, even if it should be the other way around. Don't be too eager to start celebrating yet. The schematics you've removed from there might have just been a waste of hard drive space to begin with.
Gee, I guess that UNATCO's communications lockdown wasn't worth jack shit.
Your benefactors rely too much on their Echelon protocol on Mount Weather. However, the data we deciphered from you was isolated in Berlin until we got our secure network operational.
How utterly convenient.
But your prowess will remain underappreciated as long as you work for UNATCO. You must be aware that to them you are nothing more than a prototype. And after they mass-produced all your nano-augmentations on all of their agents, they possess the means to dispose of you on nothing more than a whim? Or did they forget to mention this in the Academy?
Hierarchical systems dictating what sort of information members of certain levels may or may not know is not unique to UNATCO. Trying to kidnap someone with EMP attacks or poisonous gas certainly doesn't seem like a better alternative.
I must concede, we might have begun our cooperation on the wrong foot.
So now it's... cooperation?
Hear me out before you judge me any further, Agent Ingram. Have you ever thought about how your employers have 24/7 access to your life, and you occasionally receive a precious up bonus in return? For that matter, do you even know who your true employers are?
Becoming the first nano-augmented UNATCO agent wasn't sent to me by post in a clean, nifty package.
You didn't answer my question, Agent. Your choice of words also reveals that you're unsure of your previous choices. I wish that we can restart our cooperation from a clean table, and for that, both of us need trust. I'll take the first step. What would you say if I told you that David Yun is also in Neustadt as we speak?
Well, that sounds like yet another happy coincidence.
His apartment is close to the river of Neustadt. We've prepared an extensive collection of evidence about the true intentions of your employers and how they've tricked you and the public for their own personal glory. Meet with him and he'll instruct you on your next move. I really hope you're going to see the truth with a deceiving light.
Congratulations, Agent. Ready to go back to Neustadt?
Let's go.
Giddy up.